सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्विदाति पुरुवेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुवै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। We begin with the Chaturtha Dhyaya today, which is a Phala Dhyaya. This is a shorter chapter compared to the others. As we saw, the Sadhana Pada was the longest Sadhana Dhyaya, because Sadhana being longer, what it gives as a result, that is immediate. Unlike in Karma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, the jnana sadhana gives jnana as a phala. So when it gives that jnana as a phala, moksha is immediate. Jivan mukti as its result is immediate. In the case of krama mukti, the result is later via upasana. Where the jnana does not take place, there the phala is in the form of adrushta via upasana, ahangra upasana, and there is a Brahmaloka Prapti. As we have seen across the three chapters also, that the Upasana and Jnana go hand in hand, meaning the Krama Mukti and Jivan Mukti are both hand in hand. There is no separation done in the Sutra proper. So Brahma Sutra is focused towards Moksha. All the Sadhana is focused towards Moksha. Although Jivan Mukti is Ishta, it is possible that one does not get phala because of buddhi not being tivra, because of samshaya ityadi being there, sadhana lacking, or the sampatti, sadhana chatushte sampatti lacking. Therefore, even if there is a samshaya rahita jnanotpatti, still vasana may not let the jivan mukti ananda abhivyakti, ananda may not manifest. So that person will have Videha Mukti. There is no gati involved there. There won't be Brahmaloka Prapti there, because Jnana is without any obstacles in the form of Samshaya. But there are obstacles in the form of Vasanas, Viparita Bhavana. In the case of a person whose buddhi is not Tivra to hold on to the Jnana itself, meaning there is Samshaya every now and then for that person there is recommendation, suggestion of Ahangra Upasana. That person will have Brahmaloka Prapti, assuming that the Upasana is consistent. So this is how we will see the Phala Adhyaya. So in the Chaturtha Adhyaya, the Vyasika Nyayamala says, Chaturthe Jivato Muktihi Utkranter Gatir Uttara Brahma Prapti Brahma Loka Viti Padartha Sangraha. So here Jivataha Mukti, Jivan Mukti is also discussed. Utkrantihe Gati Uttara. So Uttara Gati, Uttarayana Marga Prapti, which leads to Swargadi Lokas, but the highest is Brahma Loka. So Brahma Loka Gati is mentioned. Therefore Brahma Prapti here and now, as well as Brahma Loka Prapti. This is the focus of this Phaladhyaya. Purvatra Sadhanam Nirupitam Iha Tat Phalam Nirupyate Iti Hetu Hetu Madbhava Sangatya Ayam Adhyaya Arabhyate. So in the earlier Adhyaya, Sadhana was discussed and it was elaborated. In this chapter, Iha Tat Phalam Nirupyate. Tat Phalam is Sadhana Phalam. This Phala of the Sadhana, what is the result to such means? That is elaborated here. Therefore, there is a hetu and hetumat bhava sangati between the earlier and this chapter. So adhyaya sangati is the third chapter is the hetu. This chapter, fourth chapter is the hetumat, is a resultant. And thereby with this sangati, this chapter is begun. Tatra purvam mokshe vishesha bhava ukta. So mokshe vishesha abhava ukta earlier. In conclusion, what was said is that there is no vishesha in moksha, in the sense there is no bheda bhava also. That is one way we can take. But if you see, in the end it was said that mukti phala aniyamaha, that is the avishesha or vishesha abhava. There is no niyama in the sense, when you compare it to jnana, whether jnana takes place here or in another loka, such kind of a niyama is not there in moksha after jnana utpatti. After jnana takes place, wherever the jnana has taken place, there itself, then and there itself is the mukti. Therefore, there is vishesha abhava. So, tatra purvam mokshe vishesha abhava uktaha. तथा श्रवणादौ आवृत्ति विशेषो नास्ति इति दृष्टांत अवांतर संगत्या इदम् अधिकरणम् आह. सो भगवान सूत्रकार ब्रिंग्स अप दिस अधिकरण इन दी फोर्थ चैप्टर द फर्स्ट अधिकरण विथ अ पूर्व पक्ष वेर जस्ट लाइक इन मोक्ष देर इज नो विशेष सिमिलरली इन श्रवण देर इज नो आवृत्ति विशेष. Shravana can be done, Shravana Adi. So Shravana Adi, Shravana Manana Nididhyasana. If someone does Shravana Manana Nididhyasana once, says the Purva Pakshi, it is sufficient. Why should there be continuous Shravana or Punaf Punaf Shravana? Because in Siddhanta, Punaf Punaf Shravana, Shravanam Kuryat. One should Shravana Adi. So Shravana is the main sadhana, Sakshat sadhana for moksha, whereas others are Sahakari. Manana and Nididhyasana are Sahakari Karana towards Jnanotpatti Moksha. So should the Avrutti, Avrutti means repetition, should there be repetition? Should one do Abhyasa of the Shravanadi? To that Purva Pakshi says no. Because Jnana will take place with Shravana, if you are saying, then it will take place with single Shravana also, says the Purva Pakshi. It may be all right, we can consider that as valid for an Uttamottam Adhikari, and those are lacking. Even in Upanishad, there are hardly any examples. There are examples, but hardly any examples of Uttamottam Adhikari, like Vamadeva Ityadi, by single Shravana or not even such kind of a Shravana in this Janma. There is Mukti by Prarabdha itself going with Janma or Shuka Ityadi. These are the examples. Otherwise, you see examples like Nachiketa, who is an Uttamadhikari. For him, Vairagya was Tivra. But then, the teaching continued across multiple chapters. He was very clear with what he wanted. So, his third question is the focus for Jnana, as Jnana Kanda. So in Katha Upanishad also we see Uttamadhikari, but then there is Avrutti, there is repetition. And Chandogya, the father is teaching the son, who is a Chaturveda Pandita. Even to that kind of a son, that kind of a Shishya, the teaching was across nine Tattvamasi Upadeshas. Navakrata Upadesha, Navakrata Upadesha or Asakrata Upadesha. So the Adhama and the Madhyama Adhikaris who are spread across Upanishad or outside also, they need to do Shravana again and again. Even if there is Jnanotpatti, Shravana should be continued, because we do not know as to what is our Prarabdha and how it can cause obstacles. Nobody knows their Vasanas which are going to be manifesting. How long is the life? What will manifest? Therefore, in Jivan Mukti Viveka, there is a the last chapter, in fact, the third and fourth chapter there, they are for Jnana Rakshana and also for Vasana Kshaya and Manonasha. So, one has to continue Shravana even after jnanotpatti, it is better to continue with the ongoing sadhana. Tatha shravanado avrutti vishesha nasti iti drishtanta avantara sangata. This is a secondary sangati. The primary sangati has been mentioned as hetu hetumat bhava sangati. And this is an avantara sangati, which is what? Drishtanta. Drishtanta sangati is avantara sangati. As to, there is no vishesha. Just like in moksha, there is no vishesha. In shravanadi also, there is no vishesha avrutti needed. Avrutti vishesha is not needed, meaning one has to continue shravana mana nidhyasana. One has to do it only once so that one gets jnana. Thereby, avrutti adhikarana is the first adhikarana. And the sutra there is avruttir asakrad upadeshat. So avruttihi asakrad upadeshat. So there are two words, avruttihi upasananam shravanadinam cha avruttihi kartavya. Avrutti, the repetition should be done. Repetition of what? Of shravanadi sadhana as well as upasanas. Upasanas for an upasaka. For an Ahangra Upasaka who is unable to understand the subtle Tattvamasi Ityadi teaching. And why is it to be done? What is the Hetu for that? Because Upanishad has Upadesha, which is Asakrut. Asakrut is, Sakrut is once. Asakrut is not once, meaning multiple times, over and one. Basically what it is, as long as jnanotpatti does not take place, there is a reason pending for understanding to be stable, samshaya rahita. As long as that doesn't happen, one has to do shravana. So jnana should be avagati paryantam. Avagati paryantam jnanam, we have seen elsewhere. So asakrat upadeshat hetuho, because of teaching itself in Upanishad itself, teaching in Upanishad itself being over and over till the Shishya understands. So long the teaching continues. Atra Purvapakshe Shravanadehe Prayajadivad Adrushtarthatvat Sakrud Anushthanam. So the Purvapakshi says that Shravanadi like Prayajadi, Prayajadi Yagas, in the Karmakanda there are so many karma, all the karmas give result in the form of Adrushta. And since Adrushta is the phala, if you do it once, it will have generated Adrushta. So similarly, Shravanadi will also generate Adrushta even if you do once. If you listen to Upanishad Mahavakya once, it will generate. Listen in the sense, you understand. So you understand the meaning when it is told to you, then it will generate. Adrushta says the Purvapakshi. In fact, he may say that if you listen and don't understand also, it will give Adrushta. Because for understanding once, the teaching once may not be sufficient. This is the Siddhanta. So Purvapakshi is saying that Shravanadi, Shravana is what? It is Shrudhatu with Lut Pratyaya. And is bhave, so listening, hearing, if you take that meaning, then it will generate adrushta. Like Veda Patha, if you chant or you listen, both will give adrushta. Similarly, Upanishad is part of Veda Shakha, and you listen to Vedas, it gives adrushta. You do karma, it gives adrushta. Similarly, you listen to Vedanta, there is no karma there, it will give adrushta. And therefore, sakrad anushthanam. This is sufficient. You do once, you will get adrushta. It will give its phala in its time. Siddhanti tu avaghatavat yavat phalam avruttihi iti phala bhedaha. So yavat phalam, as long as phala is not attained, as long as there is phala necessary, so long avruttihi, one has to continue to do shravana manana nididhyasana. This is Siddhanta. How example is avaghatavat. So two, on the other hand, Siddhanti says that avaghatavat, if you are trying to break a piece of wood, or you know, break something into two pieces, then hitting The axe once won't do. You have to do it till there are two pieces which are pratyaksha. So it is not adrushta, it is going to give you drishtaphala. Shravana manana nidhyasana is going to give you drishtaphala. So adrushtarthatvam is not there. Drishtarthatvam is there as per Siddhanti, and thereby avaghatavat, once the tree is cut, the piece of the wood that you want to cut, it is cut into pieces, whether it is two or more, it is pratyaksha. There is drishtaphala. Similarly is the shravanadi result, which is pratyaksha drishtaphala for the sadhaka, and therefore avruttihi, one should keep on doing it till one sees the result, one is able to have atma darshana, and darshana is sakshatkara. Purvam sakshadeva shrutyuktam sanyasadi sadhanam chintitam. Earlier sanyasadi sadhana was discussed. It is a sakshat sadhana, meaning sakshat shrutyukta sadhana, rather. Not sakshat sadhana, sakshat sadhana is shravana. But sanyasya shravanam kuryat is the niyama. Shravana will give result only when there is nothing else to do. When we have everything else to do and we are doing shravana also, then it will give you some result. Not all, you know, the entire result which is samshayareta jnana, that kind of a jnana does not come up because we are doing everything else which needs deha bhava. Therefore, sanyasya shravanam kuryat. For the result to take place, one has to take sannyasa, says, meaning there should be no other commitment. This is the only commitment. That can happen only when there is mumukshutvam, which is ripe. And thereby sakshadeva shrutyukta sadhana. It is sadhana. What kind of sadhana? It is sadhana which is mentioned by Shruti herself. Therefore, that is sakshad. So sakshad will go with shrutyuktam. Sakshad shrutyuktam. And thereby sannyasadi sadhana. Adi padena we can take shravana manididhyasana, which are sakshat sadhana. In which shravana is antaranga sadhana, manana and nididhyasana is bahiranga, meaning it is sahakari sadhana to sakshat sadhana, which is shravana. This was inquired into chintitam earlier. Phalam arthapatti gamyam avrutyadikam ashleshadikaranat prak chintyate. Now there is an ashleshadikarana which is going to come up. I think somewhere around the 12th sutra, after the 12th sutra, there is avrityadi which is discussed. Now this avrityadi is discussed till that ashleshadi karanat prak chintyate. So there is an inquiry done into avrityadi, whether avritti should be done or not, etc. With pramana this will be discussed, with nyaya, till the 12th sutra, which is ashleshadi karana. And what is this avritti? How do you know that avritti should be done or not? Avrityadikam is arthapatti gamyam. For that, arthapatti pramana is being used, is going to be used. And therefore, what phalam is what? Arthapatti gamyam. You understand the phala which is avrityadikam. Avrityadika phala arthapatti gamyam. You know that it is only through this kind of a sadhana. Avrityadikam. Avrityadikam. Avrityadi is the avrityadi is at the beginning. Beginning or beginning with that, and then ending with the sakshatkara is the phala really. It is known through arthapatti pramana. This is going to be inquired into till the 12th sutra or ashleshadikarana. Tatra asya adhikaranasya shravanadi sadhanam vishayaha. This adhikarana, what is the vishaya? Shravanadi sadhana. Shravana mana nidhyasana is the sadhana. This is the subject matter here. Tat kim sakrudeva kartavya uta tasya avritti kartavya iti vishaya. When the vishaya samshaya comes up as to whether the sadhana should be followed once or there should be a repetition, avritti kartavya, sakrudeva iti purva paksha. We have seen that sakrudeva, only once shravanadi is sufficient, says the purva pakshi. Siddhantastu, whereas siddhanta is shadjadi swara sakshat karavat. So there are swaras which are sixfold. So the swara is sixfold. You can take this swara as any swara, or you can take in Sangeeta Shastra also. सारे गम प ध नी, सो दिज आर दी सिक्स, एंड देन सा इज इन दी नेक्स्ट स्केल. सो यर षडजादी स्वर साक्षात्कारवत, इफ यू लिसन टू सारे गम पदन, वील कीप इट टू अ सिंपल मीनिंग है सारे गम पदन इज सा. सो इन दैट सा सेवेंथ इज द रिपीटेशन, नॉट रिपीटेशन, इन डिफरेंट स्केल, बट वेन यू लिसन टू इट वंस इज इट सफिशियंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द स्वरा. फॉर समबडी हू इज ट्रेन्ड इट इज सफिशियंट, दैट पर्सन इज एन उत्तम अधिकारी इन दी शास्त्र हियर, जस्ट लाइक इन संगीत शास्त्र हियर ऑल्सो. हु इज एन उत्तम अधिकारी हू हैज गेन्ड नॉलेज इन दी अर्लियर जन्म, लिटिल ऑब्स्टैकल इज लेफ्ट देयर, श्रवण वंस मे गिव फल. जस्ट लाइक समबडी हू हैज संगीत संस्कार, ही लिसन्स टू दी स्वराज वंस ऑल्सो, ही अंडरस्टैंड, ही गेट दी भेद, स्वर भेद, he'll understand which is which which raga ityadi also, or he'll know which are the notes which are being played. But otherwise swara sakshatkaravat durvijneya atma sakshatkarasya avrutti vishishta shravanaadi sadhyataya tadavruttir eva kartavya. So tad avruttir eva kartavya, shravanaadi avrutti should be followed as a general rule. जस्ट लाइक षडजादी स्वर साक्षात्कार इज दुर्विज्ञेय, इट इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर समबडी हू हैज नो सच संस्कार और हैज लेस संस्कार. सो दुर्विज्ञेय आत्म साक्षात्कार, दिस आत्म साक्षात्कार इज दुर्विज्ञेय लाइक दी स्वराज ऑल्सो, एंड वैदिक स्वराज वी नो दे आर इवन मोर डिफिकल्ट. द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ संगीता इज गिवन बिकॉज वन हू कैन सिंग वेल can get the Veda Swaras also easily, and one who knows chanting Vedas can understand the Sangeeta Swaras also easily, but they are not interchangeable. Interchangeable in the sense, just because one has one knowledge does not mean that the other is automatic. Just give me a moment. So one has to take efforts multiple times. It is not once. So there is no sakrad upadesha, there is asakrad upadesha in the shastra, in the Upanishad also, and elsewhere in also in the Vedanga also we see same things. So durvijnya atma sakshatkara, so this atma sakshatkara is extremely difficult because it's the subtlest of all, subtler even than even compared to akasha. So these swaras are pratyaksha. You hear the swaras, you hear the sound, but atma you don't have any access to. Yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasa, antakkarana also cannot objectify it, it is so subtle. So avrutti visishta shravanadi sadhyataya, there is definitely vishesha here, meaning avrutti vishesha should be there. पूर्वपक्षि सेड आवृत्ति विशेष नास्ति, सिद्धांत सेज आवृत्ति विशिष्ट श्रवणादि साध्यतया, इट इज अटेनेबल, दिस आत्म साक्षात्कार विच इज दुर्विज्ञेय, इट इज अटेनेबल, सोट से प्राप्त से प्राप्ति, इट इज अटेनेबल फिगरेटिवली ओनली बाय आवृत्ति विशिष्ट श्रवणादि. सो इट इज साध्य साध्यतया, इट इज अटेनेबल एज अ साध्य ओनली थ्रू श्रवणादि साधना, एंड श्रवणादि साधना विच आर आवृत्ति विशिष्ट, दे शुड बी डन अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन अवगति पर्यंतम, देयरफॉर तद आवृत्तिरेव कर्तव्या, तद आवृत्ति श्रवणादि आवृत्ति एव साधना आवृत्ति कर्तव्या एव, श्रोतव्य मंतव्य निध्यासितव्य इत्यादि असकृत उपदेशात. एंड वाई सो, बिकॉज हेतु इज यू सी श्रोतव्य आत्मा वारे द्रष्टव्य इनिशियली, सो अरे आत्मा वै द्रष्टव्य, आत्मा शुड बी हैड साक्षात्कार ऑफ, वॉट इज ई मीन्स श्रोतव्यो मंतव्यो निधिध्यासितव्य. सो श्रोतव्य मंतव्य हैज बीन सेड एंड निधिध्यासितव्य, सो हियर यू हैव निधिध्यासितव, देर इज अभ्यास कार्य देर. That shows repetition as well. Ityadi asakrut upadeshat. Otherwise, just shrotavya would have been sufficient. Why shrotavya has been mentioned once and not stopped with द उपनिषद डिड नॉट से श्रोतव्य और इट डिड नॉट इवन से आत्मावारे द्रष्टव्य एंड फुल स्टॉप सेड श्रोतव्य ओके श्रोतव्य हैज बीन सेड वंस दैट कैन बी द क्लेम ऑफ द पूर्व पक्षी श्रोतव्य सो यू डू श्रवण बट देन श्रुति डिड स्टॉप देर मंतव्य सो मनन कैन नॉट बी वंस मेंटल एक्टिविटी इंक्वायरी बुद्धि एक्टिविटी इज नॉट वंस सो मंतव्य शोज दैट देर इज रिपीटेशन मनन इज Chintana is not, oh, I have inquired into. Inquiry is not, you say something, I listen to it, I look at the padachheda ityadi, and then I'm done. It is not in that manner. So, Chintana, Manana Chintana is anyway showing avrutti. And Nididhyasitavya is with Sananta, Sananta Dhatu. So, since it is Sananta Dhatu also, although Ichharte Sananta, that takes Abhyasa Karya. So, Abhyasa is repetition. There also you see nididhyasitava, nishesha. So there is not nishesha, there is nipurvaka didhyasa dhatu. So didhyasa dhatu that jhai also is in chintana meaning. Jhai chintane, the dhatu from which the sananta dhatu has been derived. That sananta dhatu nipurvaka is also with Chintana meaning dhatu. So there is repetition of dhyana, repetition of chintana, and repetition of shravana by extension. Shrotavyaha. Because if you listen to some upadesha once, it does not stay. So one has to listen to it again as to during manana, there are some doubts which come up. So you have to go back to shravana. So therefore, shravana, manana, nididhyasana should be done continuously, ityadi. असकृत उपदेशत आदिपदेन तत्त्वमसि महावाक्य हैज बीन रिपीटेड एज वेल एवं वेद उपासित इति आवृत्ति श्रवणात एंड वेद उपासित यू कीप ऑन सीइंग दिस देयर इज वेद इज अ धातु देयर सॉरी क्रियापद उपासित इज आल्सो क्रियापद वेयर उपासना और उपासित आल्सो हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ Jnana there. Veda has the meaning of Jnana, it can have meaning of Upasana also based on the context. So the Upasana should also be repeated and for Brahmaloka Prapti and Jnana also, Jnana Vritti also has to be repeated. Iti Avritti Shravanat. You see such Kriyapadas over and over, vigiling over and over. इन दि शास्त्र इन दि उपनिषद इति आवृत्ति श्रवण उपास्य साक्षात्कार द्वारा फल हेतुषु उपासनेषु आवृत्तिर बोध्या सो इन उपासना ऑल्सो फॉर उपास्य साक्षात्कार एंड तद्वारा फल हेतुषु फला ऑफ ब्रह्मलोक विल बी देयर ओनली वाया उपास्य साक्षात्कार सो उपास्य देवता साक्षात्कार शुड टेक प्लेस एंड हियर वन इज डूइंग अहंग्रह उपासना So, Ahangra Upasana will give Brahmaloka Prapti also there. So, Phala Hetushu Upasaneshu. So, Phalam Hetuhu Yesham Upasana Nam Teshu. So, Teshu Upasaneshu, Phala Hetushu Upasaneshu. So, Upasanas are going to lead to some Phala. So, they are the Hetu for some Phala. आवृत्ति ही बोध्या वन हैज टू अंडरस्टैंड रिपीटेशन देर एज वेल फर्दर किंच मोर ओवर इन कंटिन्यूएशन लिंगाच देर इज लिंग प्रमाण ऑल्सो सो सूत्रार्थ है सिंपल लिंग प्रमाण इज ऑल्सो देर वे वॉट इज द लिंग देर रश्मींस त्वं पर्यावर्तयात इति रश्मि बहुत्व उपासनम विदधत वाक्यम प्रत्यावृत्तिम दर्शयति सो The Chandogya Vakya as to Rashmin Sutam Paryavartayat. There is a teaching as to Kaushitaki told his putra. He says that may you have many putras also. And he said that I made a mistake that I have only single son. I have only one son in the form of your presence. He tells the son that you beget more children. Because children are also considered as dhana, Lakshmi. So here, in the Upanishad context, the father teaches the son as to how the upasana has to be done. he said that I focused on a single, you know, single aspect of the upasana, but you focus on multiple rays, not single ray. Or the way I did, you focus on rashmi. Rashmis are many. Surya rashmi, surya kirana, the rays of sunlight. So if you do upasana on multiple rays, rashmi bahutva upasanam, because I focused on a single ray of Surya, I got a single child. If you focus on multiple rays, you will get the sun rays, you will get Bahuputra. So, Bahuputra labhaya rashmi bahutva upasanam vidadat. So, that statement, vakya, which is teaching this, vaya the akhyayika, Kaushitake is teaching his son as to you do rashmi bhautva upasanam. How? Rashmin stvam, tvam rashmin paryavartayat. You do upasana with multiple sun rays. Vidadat vakyam pratyavrtim darshayati. It shows as to, since multiple rays are there, you have to keep on repeating this upasana. So there is an avritti. It's a linga. So this rashmi bhautva is a linga for upasana avritti. Thereby, there is a linga pramana also in upasana also to be repeated, because upasana, just like manasika karma, in karma kanda also there are karmanga ashrita upasanas. Similar to those, the independent upasanas also are going to give you adrushta, said the purvapakshi. Therefore, doing it once is sufficient. Siddhanti says, no, there is linga pramana also, that upasanas also have to be repeated. Karmanga ashrita upasanas are to be done only along with the karma. If they are being done, they have to be done only during the karma. But we have shown that some karmanga ashrita upasanas are not really ashrita, they are independent also. If they are independent, they have to be done over and over again. They'll give ekagrata, they'll give chitta shuddhi also via adrushta. But ahangraha upasanas, which are independent upasanas, they will lead to jnanotpatti also. How is questionable? It comes up in the 9th chapter of Panchadashi, where the Purvapakshi says that this Nirguna Brahma Upasana is not going to be possible. It is impossible. How can one do Upasana on Nirguna? Because it is never Vishaya to Dhyana. It is not Dhyana Vishaya. It cannot become Dhyana Vishaya. How will you do Nirguna Brahma Upasana? To that, Siddhanti says that this objection is valid to Jnana also. Jnadhatu Karma cannot be Nirguna Brahma as well. Same objection is applicable to Jnana also. The way jnana can take place regarding Nirguna Brahma, similarly upasana also is possible regarding Nirguna Brahma. Nirguna upasana is definitely there. It is subtle, it is difficult, but you cannot say it is not possible. It will work in a similar manner as the jnana. That itself is not the phala. We are not saying that it is a phala, but it is possible that somebody who has had shravana and is unable to grasp, he may be able to grasp, because the upasana paves the way for jnanotpatti. Example given there is in the 9th chapter of, I think 9th chapter of Panchadashi, there Siddhanti gives an example. He says that I cannot explain how this takes place, but I'll give an example as to it can take place in similar manner. The example is of a brahmachari who is trying to recollect his Veda Patha, his Swashakha. He has tried throughout the day. He is unable to recall some parts. He is unable to chant. He has to go back and refer. He is unable to recollect what he has heard during the teaching. Now, being exhausted, being tired, he sleeps off. But as soon as he wakes up in the morning, he is able to chant. There are many things that we don't recollect, but when we sleep and then as soon as we wake up, we recollect. How does that happen? We can't explain. Something happened during the sleep whereby obstacles are gone. Whether the mind is more focused, it is rested, whatever reasoning can be given, it can be taken as valid or invalid, but it does take place. It is anubhav siddha to everyone in some aspect or the other. So an example is given as to how this brahmachari is able to recollect his swashaka, veda mantras he is able to recollect, which he was not able to recollect. It is because of obstacles going, and therefore similarly this upasana also can take away obstacles. Ahangra upasana or nirguna brahma upasana can take away obstacles, and shravana which was done earlier one is able to understand. Therefore those who are unable to follow shravanadi and stay the course, meaning understand the meaning without any objections from the buddhi, they can follow nirguna brahma upasana और अहंग्रह उपासना. अतः तल्लिंगात तन्याया, तल्लिंगात मीन्स देर इज न्याय. यू सी लॉजिकली रश्मि बहुत्व इज बीन मेंशन, सो द उपासना ऑल्सो आवृत्ति प्रत्यावृत्ति. इन दैट वाक्य वी सी लिंगा मीनिंग न्याय एज टू वॉट साक्षात्कार साधनेशु आवृत्ति कर्तव्य इत्यर्थः. साक्षात्कार साधनेशु there should be avritti done for sakshatkara, sakshatkara. In the sadhana there should be repetition. So sadhana is what shravanadi. Therefore shravanadi should be repeated when you take jnana proper. If you consider brahmaloka prapti sadhana upasana, there also avritti kartavya. It is applicable for both. Purvatra shravanadehe avritti rukta tam upajivya kinchid vicharyate iti upajivya upajivaka bhava sangatya idamaha. So there is a upajivya upajivaka bhava sangatya. This adhikarana has dependency on the earlier adhikarana, because shravanadehe avritti ukta, shravanadi repetition is established in the earlier adhikarana. So this adhikarana that is coming up has basis in the earlier. It can live, it can survive only on the earlier adhikarana. Therefore there is an upajivya upajivaka bhava sangat. It is a literal translation. So upajivya upajivaka, so the foundation is in the earlier adhikarana. That's the meaning there. Atmatto atmatto upanadha adhikaranam. What is this? There seems to be a typo there. No, it's atmatto. So there is a typo there. Atmatva upasana adhikaranam. There is sa missing there. So atmatva upasana adhikaranam. Atmatva upasana adhikaranam. There is a typo. Sa should be read before the na there. The sutra there is atmeti tu upagacchanti grahayanti cha. Atmeti tu upagacchanti grahayanti cha. So brahma atma iti, atma iti means brahma atma iti pratyaktvena, pratyagatma, my real swarupa which is atma, that is nothing but brahma. Tu upagacchanti grahayanti cha shrutaya. The shruti itself talks about it, meaning talks about the pratyagatma as brahma. So atma and brahma are in samanadikaranyam. The shabdas are in samanadikaranyam. The shruti as to tattvamasi or tvam vaham asmi bhagavo devate aham vai tvamasi, which is quoted in the vritti. So brahma abhyupagacchanti, upagacchanti means abhyupagacchanti. It makes the sadhaka understand and thereby attain one's own swarupa. Attainment is figurative because it is by neti neti prakriya. I am not anything other than Brahma. That is the real meaning there. So here when Shruti says upagacchanti, it is not as to one physically approaches this jnana. So jnana is in the, it's a buddhi. Buddhi has the vritti, that's what it means. So similar is the case here of Tattvamasi or Tomvaham Asmi Bhagavo Devate Aham Vai Tomasi. So it is interchangeable. There is a Mukhya Samana Adhikaranyam. That is the Grahayanti cha. So Grahayanti is what? Grahayanti is Nijanta. So it makes a person understand and grasp the meaning by Asakrut Upadesha only. So Asakrut Upadesha is a foundation which has gone by, and thereby Shruti, by repetition over and over and over, not in not Shabdata only. Sometimes it is Shabdata repetition, but it has does not have any dosha. One, because the matter is settled. Second, because the it is having different objection or different inquiry. So the context in which the same set of words have come up, that context varies. Shabda may be same, but the context varies. Therefore, the question of the sadhaka is different. So in Chandogya 6th chapter, when Tattvamasi Mahavakya Upadesha is given 9 times, although the literal meaning of the Mahavakya is same, still there is no dosha. One, because the matter is subtle, it is very difficult to understand. So there, when the subtle matter is being discussed, there is no dosha in, there is no Punarukti dosha. But even if we have an objection of Karmakandi saying that no, it is a Punarukti dosha, we can take it away by saying that the context is different. If you see the progression of the Akhyayika Samvada between the Acharya and the Shishya, Guru Shishya Samvada, you see how the question shapes up, and thereby you will know between two Upadeshas how the mind of the questioner has changed. So is slowly progressing towards that. Therefore, Grahayanti cha. The Shishya approaches with a question, and the Shruti makes the Shishya understand with the same set of words in the end, but with a different example. With a different example, different aspect of the doubt is shattered. Thereby, all doubts get shattered in the 9th Upadesha, and then Shvetaketu says, now I understand. Till then he has asked, please again, Punareva, Punareva, please tell me again and again and again with a different example. And with a different example, the Guru explains. So same setup is applicable everywhere across Upanishad, where Avritti is seen, and through that, Shrutihi, Upagachanti, Grahayanti cha. Shrutayaha, you can say Shrutaya because it is Bahuvachana. So atra Purvapakshe Shrutinam Abheda Paranam Gaunarthattvam Siddhante Mukhyarthattvam iti Phalabhedaha. As we saw, the Upajivya Upajivaka Bhava has come up in the introduction, that Sangati. So the Purvapaksha was not mentioned. Otherwise, usually Purvapaksha is mentioned. We see that Purvapaksha is mentioned. Now that Purvapaksha is mentioned in the Vritti after the Sutra. What is the Purvapaksha? Shrutinam Abheda Paranam Gaunarthattvam. The Tattvamasi Aham Brahmasmi Mahavakyas are all what? They are Gauna. They have Gauna Artha, says the Purvapakshi, which are committed to showing Abheda, but they don't have literal meaning. They are not in Swartha. Siddhante Mukhyarthattvam, meaning Swartha. They mean real Samanadikarana, meaning Brahma is Atma, Atma is Brahma. It is not Gauna, it is not Stutipara, it does not have any other context than Brahmajnana itself. Therefore, there is Mukhyarthattvam. Iti Phalabhedaha. Tatra kim Shravanadhyavrutti kale Pratyaktvena Brahma Dhyatavyam Uta Bhinnatvena iti Vishe Naham Ishwara iti Pratyaksha Virodhat Bhinnatvena iti Purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says, when the doubt comes up, what is the doubt? Whether the Upasana also, Dhyana or Nididhyasana also, you can take Nididhyasana also and Upasana, Ahangra Upasana also. When such Vakyas come up, if one is able to understand, should one take this understanding and stay the course, do Nididhyasana also एज आई एम ब्रह्म अभिन्नत्वेन, सो प्रत्यक्त्वेन ब्रह्म श्रवणाद्य आवृत्ति काले, वेन यू हैव रिपीटेशन ऑफ श्रवण शुड यू होल्ड ऑन टू द अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट आई एम बाय स्वरूप ब्रह्म एंड देयर बाय निधिध्यासन ऑल्सो शुड टेक प्लेस इन दैट मैनर, और अहंग्रह उपासना इफ यू आर डूइंग वन शुड डू दिस आवृत्ति विथ ब्रह्म भाव और उत भिन्नत्वेन, और शुड वन कंसिडर दैट नो दिस परमात्मा इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम मी. वेन सच डाउट कम्स अप, पूर्व पक्षी सेज न अहम ईश्वर, अहम ईश्वर न अस्मी, नास्मी, दिस इज प्रत्यक्ष. सो सिंस देर इज अ प्रत्यक्ष विरोध एज टू आई एम नॉट ईश्वर, आई एम नॉट द जगत्कर्ता, देर फोर भिन्नत्वेन इति पूर्वपक्ष. पूर्वपक्षी सेज नो देर शुड बी उपासना विद भिन्नत्व, वन शुड कंसिडर दैट आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म इवन वेन द टीचिंग इज तत्वमसी. सिद्धांतस्तु, वेरा सिद्धांति सेज आत्मा इत्येव ब्रह्म ध्यातव्यम्. आत्मा इट्सेल्फ, माय ओन स्वरूप इज नथिंग बट ब्रह्म, जगत कारण ब्रह्म. दिस इज हाउ वन शुड अंडरस्टैंड एंड होल्ड ऑन टू इट इन ध्यान ऑल्सो और इन निधिध्यासन. तथा ही जाबाला आत्मत्वेन ब्रह्म अभ्युपगच्छन्ति. सो जाबाला श्रुतय ऑल्सो और दोज हु फॉलो द जाबाला श्रुति देव, मीनिंग इन द जाबाला श्रुति व्हाट डू यू हियर, आत्मत्वेन ब्रह्म अभ्युपगच्छन्ति. वेर इज द वाक्य लाइक दैट, त्वं वाहमस्मि भगवः देवते अहं वै त्वमसि इति. सो देर यू सी जाबाला श्रुति विच इज अ महावाक्य देर, विच हैज अ महावाक्य देर एज टू वॉट, त्वं वा अहमस्मि, और अदर वे राउंड ऑल्सो, हे देवते, भो देवते, भगवः, ओ देवता, ओ भगवान, त्वं अहमस्मि, और त्वं वा अहम इज ऑल्सो वॉट, वा इज वै दे, वै वै अहमस्मि, और सो दि वर्णमेलन, वर्णमेलन और दि संधि, संधि देर कैन बी सीन ए छांदस ऑल्सो, वा अहम, नॉट वाहम, वा अहम ऑल्सो कैन बी सीन एज सेपरेटली, देर वा वुड बी वै, और वा अहम, इफ वै हैज बिकम वा, देर देर शुड बी नो संधि देर, आफ्टर लोपशाकल्य देर शुड बी नो संधि, एंड दैट संधि कैन बी सीन एज छांदस देर. Or one can say as va as in another manner also you can see. So in the context you can see it in multiple ways, but this Siddhanta is what? Tvam aham asmi and aham tvam asi. Both ways it has been mentioned. You pick one or the other or both, you will get the same meaning. We'll take both. We'll take both to establish Mukhya Samana Adhikaran. We'll say tvam vai aham asmi and aham vai tvam asi. Both are, both ways it has been mentioned. Just like if you see, Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma is only one way equation. Meaning, everything is a manifestation of Brahma. Meaning, there is a dependent existence of the entire prapancha on Brahma, Brahmatma, on me. The drashta, shrota, manta, ityadi. On me, there is a dependency of all the padarthas for their satta and spurti. Whereas I, Brahma, do not have dependency on them. Therefore, their equation is not aham or Brahma sarvam asti. The equation is only one way. But here, there is a mukhya samanadikaranam. There it is bada samanadikaranam. In sarvam khalvidam Brahma, there is bada samanadikaranam. Sarvam nasti tyartha. Sarvam nasti, Brahma eva asti. And Brahma aham asmi, therefore aham eva asmi, Brahmatvena aham eva asmi, sarvam jagat nasti, prapanchah nasti, that is the meaning there. So, tvam va aham asmi, bhagava devate aham vai tvam asi shows mukhya samanadikaranam. This is how Brahma abhyupagachyanti, they understand Brahma in this manner, as oneself, or Atma in this manner, as Brahma, both ways. Tatha grahayanti cha, and दिस इज हाउ दी श्रुति टीचेस ऑल्सो. नॉट ओनली डू यू अंडरस्टैंड इन दिस मैनर, इट इज ओनली बिकॉज द टीचिंग इन दिस मैनर, द टीचिंग मेक्स यू अंडरस्टैंड इन दिस मैनर. ब्रह्म आत्मत्वेन तत्त्वमसि इत्यादि वाक्यानि ग्राहयन्ति च. देर इज अ कॉजेटिव, ज्ञान इज कॉजेटिव, इट इज अ रिजल्टेंट ऑफ श्रवण एंड दि श्रुति श्रुतया श्रावयन्ति च. सो ग्राहयन्ति च, दे मेक यू ग्रास्प हाउ श्रावयन्ति च. दिस इज हाउ दे मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय श्रुति, बाय रिवीलिंग युअर स्वरूप टू यू एज ब्रह्म. न च तेषां नाम ब्रह्म इत्यादि गौणार्थत्वं. नाम ब्रह्म इति उपासीत, देर इज गौणत्वं देर. नाम ब्रह्म इति उपासीत, सो इति उपासीत, नाम इज नॉट ब्रह्म बट नाम ब्रह्म इति उपासीत. इन दिस मैनर यू डू उपासना इत्यादिवत गौणार्थत्वं न. दीज महावाक्यास डू नॉट हैव कमिटमेंट टू समथिंग एल्स. मीनिंग इट इज नॉट दैट यू हैव ब्रह्म दृष्टि इन इन यूअर सेल्फ बट यू आर नॉट ब्रह्म, दैट इज नॉट द मीनिंग. नाम इज नॉट रियली ब्रह्म बट यू हैव ब्रह्म दृष्टि इन नाम. सो हैविंग दैट ब्रह्म दृष्टि इज एन उपासना वेर नाम इज नॉट रियली ब्रह्म बट फॉर सम अदृष्ट फला दिस इज हाउ यू डू उपासना. हाउएवर इन महावाक्यास देर इज नो सच गौणार्थ बिकॉज इट इज स्वार्थपरा. इट इज नॉट अन्यपरा, इट इज स्वार्थपरा. देयरफॉर मुख्यार्थत्व इज देर. सति मुख्यार्थत्व गौणार्थत्व अयोगात. व्हाट इज द हेतु, व्हाई डू यू से देर इज नो गौणार्थता? बिकॉज सति मुख्यार्थते, मुख्यार्थत्व सति. इफ मुख्यार्थ कैन बी एक्सप्लेन, इट कैन बी अंडरस्टूड इन स्वार्थ, देन नो स्टेटमेंट, नो वेदवाक्य शुड बी इंटरप्रिटेड विद अ सेकेंडरी मीनिंग. लक्षण इत्यादि कैन बी डन ओनली वेन द मुख्यार्थ इज नॉट पॉसिबल. It is impossible. Or there is contradiction with something else. If there is no contradiction, mukhyartha is possible, why would you take gaunartha? Nacha pratyakshadi virodha. And Pura Pakshya says, naham ishvara iti pratyaksha virodha is there. No such pratyaksha virodha is there. Why? Says the Siddhanti, tasya mithya bheda gocharatvena. The bheda that is pratyaksha to you between ishvara and you is mithya. Why? Because शरीर इज मिथ्या, शरीर संबंध इज मिथ्या, दि कोश संबंध, कोश इज मिथ्या, कोश संबंध इज मिथ्या, विद दि उपाधि ऑल दि भेद कैन बी एक्सप्लेन. देयरफॉर मिथ्याभेद गोचरत्वेन, थ्रू मिथ्याभेद अंडरस्टैंडिंग वन कैन अंडरस्टैंड दि भेद प्रतीति ऑफ वन सेल्फ फ्रॉम ईश्वर. सो पारमार्थिक अभेद गोचरत्वाद इति भावः. थ्रू मिथ्या भेद अंडरस्टैंडिंग वन अंडरस्टैंड्स दैट उपाधि भेद हैज कॉज डिफरेंसेस बट देर इज नो रियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन परमार्थ परमात्मा एंड मी. देयरफॉर पारमार्थिक अभेद इज देयर. मिथ्या भेद इज व्यावहारिक भेद, व्यावहारिक भेद. मिथ्या एंड व्यावहारिक आर इंटरचेंजेबल वर्ड बट पारमार्थिक, इन परमार्थ देर इज नो भेद, देर इज अभेद. सो पारमार्थिक अभेद गोचरत्वात् इति भावः. सो मिथ्या, इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड भेद एज मिथ्या, देन इट विल लीड टू पारमार्थिक अभेद अंडरस्टैंडिंग. अभेद इज रियल वेर एज भेद इज व्यावहारिक मिथ्या इति भावः. दिस इज द मीनिंग देर. विल स्टॉप हियर, विल कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ. आमने तेक संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम पूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.